Look at this table. These are the countries with the most people with natural red hair in the world. As you can see, Scotland is number one, with between 10 and 13% of Scots having this colour. Yet globally, red hair is the rarest hair colour in the world, found in only 1 to 2% of people. But why do so many Scottish people have red hair? Has this always been the case? And did red hair originate in Scotland? Now, we know that the primary cause of red hair is a mutation in the MC1R gene located on chromosome 16. And to actually express this trait, you must inherit one copy of this MC1R variant from each parent, as it is a recessive trait. Yet that doesn't mean that people need to have red hair expressed themselves for them to have a red haired child, as many people silently carry this MC1R mutation. And we know this is the case in Scotland, as around 40% of the Scottish population carry the red hair gene variant, which is obviously much higher than the actual frequency of red hair at between 10 and 13%. We also know that people with red hair also tend to have fair skin, freckles, lighter eyes, and also a heightened sensitivity to UV light in general, although this can vary by person. But did red hair originate in Scotland, and is it connected to the Neanderthals at all? Well, we do know that red hair has been a feature in these lands for millennia. As the Roman historian Tacitus wrote in the 1st century AD, for example, when he was writing about the Caledonians, one of the ancient peoples of Scotland, writing about their physical appearance, how they looked in general. He wrote that, "The red hair and large limbs of the inhabitants of Caledonia proclaim their Germanic origin." So red hair was a noted feature in ancient Scotland at the time of the Romans around 2000 years ago. Yet the origin of red hair was not in ancient Scotland. It is far older and broader than any one country in general, but it probably didn't even originate in Europe. The most likely location was in Central Asia, with this mutation arising tens of thousands of years ago. And we do see elevated levels of red hair in some peoples of this region, with the Udmurt people of Russia a famous example of this today. Down through history as well, we see groups from this part of the world with this trait, with this fiery red hair. The Budini, for instance, who were an ancient Scythian tribe from this region, were known for their red hair, as described by Herodotus, the father of history. And what is even more interesting is that there are various references to Scythia in the origin stories of both the Scots and the Picts, which is a curious connection. And let me know in the comments below if you would like a specific video on this link between the Scythians and the Scots and the Picts. But how did the Neanderthals fit into all of this? Could we have inherited this trait of red hair from our ancient human cousins? Well, we do know that the Neanderthals had their own version of this MC1R mutation that caused red hair and pale skin. A 2017 study published in the American Journal of Human Genetics found that none of the variants that cause red hair in modern humans were present in Neanderthal samples, however, but they had their own variants that caused red hair in rare cases. In other words, we didn't inherit red hair from our ancient human cousins from the Neanderthals, yet they did also have red hair, but this was caused by a slightly different genetic mutation in the same general area, which is pretty interesting in and of itself. As both Neanderthals and modern humans followed different evolutionary paths to the same red-headed appearance. Now, if you're enjoying this video, please consider subscribing. And if you'd like access to member-only videos, please check out the top link in the video description below. I've made a member-only video recently on Frisian DNA, one of the ancient ancestors of the English, and I've also made videos on Viking DNA differences and other topics. Like I say, please check out the top link in the video description below, and thank you for all your support in general. But when was the red hair genetic mutation first introduced to Scotland, and by who? Well, we do know that Western hunter-gatherers largely had dark brown hair. And from our understanding, at least at the moment, they didn't seem to have this MC1R mutation in any great number. This is a similar story for early European farmers, the second foundational population in Scottish DNA. Yet the third ancestral component changed things. This was when steppe ancestry arrived during the Bronze Age. This ancestry traced its route to the Yamnaya people just north of the Black Sea, and in modern-day Ukraine, a region known in the ancient world as Scythia, which is quite interesting. Now, connected peoples to the Yamnaya helped spread this ancestry across Europe, notably the Belbikers in the west. Thus, The first red-haired person in the land we call Scotland today was almost certainly a Bellbeaker-descended individual living around 4,000 years ago, carrying one of the earliest MC1R mutations introduced by the steppe ancestry. Now, later waves of migration and invasion likely reinforced these genes as well. We know, for instance, that the Vikings had a decent impact on Scottish DNA and a heavy influence on Orkney and Shetland to the north. Now, although we often think about blonde hair with the Norse, with the Vikings in general, some Vikings also did carry red-haired genes. For example, the Viking explorer Erik the Red is said to have gotten his name from the colour of his hair or beard. So while the origin of red hair probably wasn't Scotland, we know this is obviously a trait that thrived in Scotland over the centuries and over the millennia. But why is this though? Why do so many Scottish people have red hair, and obviously people of Scottish ancestry around the world as well? Well, one main theory is rooted in climate and evolution. Now, redheads often have very fair skin that we know is more efficient at producing vitamin D from sunlight. In the cloudier northern climates of Britain and Ireland, this would be beneficial. Biologists have suggested that over many generations, individuals carrying the MC1R mutations may have avoided vitamin D deficiency and related diseases like rickets, giving them a slight health and fertility edge in low sunlight environments. Thus, over generations, the cloudy climate could have helped nudge the gene pool towards fair skin and red hair for better vitamin D production. And if you think of most people that have red hair, such as myself or red tints to their hair, they often have quite fair skin. But this can't be the only explanation, as we know that various other countries have similar climates, similar environments to Scotland and Britain and Ireland in general. So what are some other factors? Well, another one is probably the relative genetic continuity in Scotland, and Ireland and Wales for that matter, that has meant that red-haired genes never faced a major dilution event in later history. This was different from parts of England, for instance, which saw large migrations from the likes of the Anglo-Saxons. Now, if you look at this table, you can see that Anglo-Saxons had lower levels of red hair than Celtic Britons, the previous people of England prior to the Anglo-Saxon migrations. And when we look at traits in England today, eastern parts with high Anglo-Saxon ancestry tend to have lower levels of red hair, reflecting this historical pattern. Now, the geography of Scotland could be another factor as well. Scotland's rugged geography and somewhat isolated communities, especially in the Highlands and the Islands, also limited gene flow from other populations as well. This allowed recessive traits like red hair to persist and become more prevalent, creating an ideal environment for genetic drift to make this trait more pronounced. There could have been a founder effect as well. Now, in general, when it comes to Scottish DNA, we know that the Scottish genetic landscape echoes the DNA of past kingdoms. This is what a fascinating study published in 2019 found, published in PNAS, called The Genetic Landscape of Scotland and the Isles. The authors found that many genetic boundaries in modern Scotland are consistent with Dark Age kingdoms of the Gaels, the Picts, the Britons and the Norse. They added that populations in the Hebrides, the Highlands and Argyll also show characteristics of isolation. So in other words, Scotland has been relatively genetically isolated over the centuries. And even when outside groups have influenced the gene pool, such as the Vikings, they also carried these red-haired genes to some degree. And if you look at the founding groups of Scotland in general, in the form of the Gaels, the Picts and the Britons of Strathclyde, they are all Atlantic peoples from the same general area. And they also have similar genetics, strongly influenced by the Bellbeakers during the Bronze Age, dominated by R1b, L21 on the Y-DNA side, for instance. So the reason why Scotland has so many redheads is likely a combination of many factors. Mainly climate, genetic drift, and the relative genetic isolation characterised by the lack of a major dilution event. And over time, red hair became a symbol of Celtic identity. The Gaelic name Ruri, for instance, means Red King. This name is believed to have emerged during the times of ancient Celtic rulership, when red hair was considered a prestigious trait, symbolising power and leadership. Now, sexual attractiveness could also be another factor as well, influencing the frequency and the overall gene pool. But what do you think? Please let me know in the comments below and what your hair colour is. But what is the genetic history of Scotland, and what are the main haplogroups in the country today? Well, to find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.